WDSU first warning weather. We've got an impact day still for heat, and we have more impact days to come for the heat as well. We got to talk tropics, and that's where we're going to start, because there's new information that's been coming in to say that we've now got kind of a couple of potentials that are starting to get a little bit more equal in likelihood or potential. So here's where the system of the tropical wave is over the Lesser Antilles right now, barreling right in towards Puerto Rico, our U.S. territory, showers and storms associated with that. So take a look at this system. A lot more storm activity than what we have found, well, since ever we've identified this system, but it's very broad still. Now, there is dry air around. You can see the Saharan dust was still there. However, the storms are starting to blossom enough that we're starting to eat up a lot of that drier air and just dash in and enhance the humidity by the storms themselves. So these are our two best forecasts. This one comes out of Europe. It has been forecasting it would be caught up in the Bermuda High, starts to bend through the Bahamas, then off the east coast of the United States. Take a look what's starting to happen today. Taking it on more of a southern route, possibly through Cuba, then maybe through the Florida Straits, and watch what happens here. We start to see potential. This is into the eastern Gulf. This is Tampa's problem right here. This is Monday evening. So this is still a long, long ways away. Then that forecast shows potentially coming and migrating eastward right in through the Florida Peninsula and then out and towards the Atlantic Ocean by next Thursday. That's just one forecast. Our forecast out of the United States, a similar track to begin with by Friday morning. It's to near Cuba. But then watch it through the Florida Straits here in similar position as we get into the weekend by Sunday evening. Look at this forecast, though. It has it more meandering around northern Florida and then forecast data beyond this time period into next week. Just kind of spinning its way out and possibly making some westward progression there. But that's a long, long ways from now. So it's starting to show is there are two particular tracks in competition with themselves, and it's all due to the placement of where that Bermuda High will be. That will be the key. But right now, there is a little movement west, still low probabilities that there are direct impacts to us. Stay with us. WDSU.com, great resource. Meteorologist Jim Sine was putting some extra info on things here today.